top I'm looking at this microscope. It's a digital microscope and it goes from 1 to 1200 magnification. And I was wondering whether it'd be any use in the workshop instead of a magnifying glass, and whether you could check things like threads, pitch, angles using this. So let's go to the workshop, see how it works. Now today I'm doing a tool review on this portable LCD digital microscope. I bought this to check out whether it'd be any good in the workshop instead of using magnifying glasses. I was trying to measure a screw thread a few days ago and found that under a magnifying glass I couldn't really measure anything. I thought, how would I have done it in an engineering company? I used to have a thing called a shadow graph, and that's what I'd use to measure the thread. I thought, well, that's similar to a microscope. So I've got this to see whether it is useful in the workshop and how good it is. Let's have a look what we get in the box. Instructions. And that makes a change. Normally they're printed that small, you can't read them without having a magnifying glass. The working part of the microscope. The screen is a 7-inch screen. Camera under there and some LED lights around the outside. Under the cover we have adjustment arm. There's a stand. Then you get USB charger, which is a European type socket. Adapter for UK, which doesn't look too clever. And a USB charging lead. Now to assemble the microscope, that just screws into the base. The base has four hard rubber feet on the bottom, a couple of cap heads holding the bracket, rack and pinion to get the focus. Now one of the features I say is you can put this back at 45 degrees, so if you're looking at something on here like electrical components, you can see them at an angle. You have two screws on the top here, both have rubber pads on the end. And the lens or the microscope part just slides into that holder. Now before I lock that up, we'll have a look at the microscope. We'll just go through some of the buttons. This is the on-off button, and you have to hold that down for 2 seconds for it to work. Then you've got an M key, which is a function setting key, which is there. A D key, which is a key to set your camera and different parameters of the camera. Up and down arrow keys, an OK key, and then here is a little LED, so if you have it on charge it will tell you when the battery's charged. Now what surprised me is that this has a battery fitted. It's sealed in, you can't take it out. I thought it was just run on a USB lead from a mains adapter, which it does. So you can run it on a battery that's built in or a USB mains adapter. So we'll look at the side. This knob here is for focus. On the side here we have the USB socket. We have a micro memory card socket. And also we have a rotary switch here for turning the LEDs on and off and the controlling the brightness of the LEDs around the camera. The camera lens is in the middle and these are the LEDs around the outside to give you light onto the subject. The screen size is 7 inches. I'll fit that on the stand and we'll have a look. It's quite easy to fit on, just drop it on, tighten the two screws up. Switch it on, you hold the power button down for 2 seconds. Okay, on the screen you see the finish of the base, which is like a shot blast finish. Here we have the battery condition. Above it's telling me there's no memory card in the back of the microscope. Over this side it's saying it's set up to take photos, and if I press the D button it's now set up to take video. I've just put a 5mm cap head underneath. That is the lowest magnification. I think it's right at the top of the scale. And all you do to select the magnification, just lower the head down. You see it goes out of focus. And all you do is turn the knob to focus it up. And you can see the form of the thread. So if I go down to the fullest magnification, which is about there, let's move it to the edge of the thread, focus on the camera. There you can see the form of the thread, the depth of the thread. Let's go through some of the settings, take that out. If you press the M button, hold it in, it tells me there I'm on 1080 full HD. Press it again. I can set various details by just using the up and down arrow. So if I press enter on that one, you can see I can have the LCD brightness. I haven't turned the LCD lights on yet. Auto power off, frequency, language, date, time, format. And you can have an exposure, and date stamp. So at any time you can take a picture of what you're looking at, or a video, and it'll put the date, time on. Still photos or a video. You can set the screen to turn off. Automatically turn off. Focus that up on the base. You can see the shot blast base. So in video mode you have a resolution of 1080 or 720 or VGA, and it will film for 3 minutes, 5 minutes or 10 minutes, or until the card's full, and then it will film over the data that's already on the card. In photo mode, you can have a single photo, photos for 2 seconds, 5 seconds, or 10 seconds, and the pixels are 1.3, 2, 5, 8, 10, or 12, and that depends on what you select. You can have colour, black and white, ISO is from 100 up to 400. So let's have a look at something else under the microscope. Put a cutting tool underneath. You can focus here by turning the knob. Or if you don't want to do that, you want to go down further, you can just move the camera down and refocus. Let's move the tip in the center. Here's the cutting edge. So it's useful for if you're sharpening your own tools, you can see what the cutting edge is like. If I go right down, you can see there the cutting edge of the tool. At the moment, I've done all this without the LED lamps being on. So if you want to turn the lamps on, you just, if I turn the switch on the side, you can see the light start to come on. And that can be adjusted, that's full power, or you can just turn it down slightly. There's the cutting tip. You can go focus it up here. So if I go as close as possible, you can see the insert, the edge of the insert, and even the wear on the tool. So I'm quite pleased with this. I've got some other plans for it to be able to measure in the X and Y direction and turn this into a measuring machine. Okay, I've changed the tool for a circuit board. So let's have a look how that looks under the microscope. Let's focus up with the up and down movement. Here you can see two soldered spots. Now I can zoom in on that and see if I can move it across to something a bit smaller. You can see on the circuit board you can move the part easy to see. And if you've got an integrated circuit on there, you can tilt the microscope camera to 45 degrees so you can see the legs on the side rather than looking down on them. Okay, I've put an SD card in and we'll have a look at the quality of the pictures. Now this is on movie here. Now I just press OK and it's flashing a red spot there and it's telling me it's full HD and I've taken 10 seconds of movie, so I'll press OK again. And it stops. Now if I press D, it goes on to photos. I'm set to 2 megapixels here. You can alter this to whatever size you like. I don't know. I'll have to go into the program to do that. Come down to photo resolution. Okay. And select, let's say 10 megapixels, okay. Go back to photo again. It's on 7 megapixels. So if I press OK, takes a photo. If I change the focus a bit, press OK, changes colour here, then goes back, so it's taken another photo. So let's say we want to see the photos. There's the photo, 10 megapixels. There's a small instruction pamphlet with it, user manual. As I say, the printing is not small, so you don't need a microscope to look at the printing. Very useful for electronics. If you're soldering something small, you need to see what you're doing. And with this, you can focus it up and then do the job that you need to do. And it will still stay focused on the part that you're soldering. There you can see the form of the thread quite easily. So I'm pleased with this. It's easy to use. And once you have it on an SD card, you can put it on your computer. Well, that's it for today. I hope that was useful. Hope you enjoyed it. And we'll see you next time on Enoch's Engineering.